Now that you know how to implement methods, let's move on to constructors. You want to be able to create variations of objects, for example, a car that's very fuel efficient or a car that is less so. In Java, you use constructors to initialize objects. Here is an example. In the body of the constructor, we simply initialize the instance variables. The first two here are set to a constant value. When a car is first created, it has not driven any miles and its tank is empty. This instance variable is set to a parameter. That allows you to construct cars with different properties. Here, we construct a car with 60 miles per gallon. The value 60 is passed into the parameter variable and is then set to the instance variable here. Over here, we construct a car with 5 miles per gallon. And again, the 5 is passed into the parameter variable and then used to initialize this instance variable. A couple of things to pay attention to when you define a constructor. Note the name. It's the same as the class name. The class is called car. The constructor is called car. Also note that there's no return type at all, not even void. A constructor is not a method. It does not return any value. Instead, the job of a constructor is simply to initialize the instance variables. You can have more than one constructor, and you'll get a chance to write one right now. Here is our constructor in BlueJ. You see the statements that we had just before, together with a couple of statements that set the car's picture. Now, this constructor always takes the same picture to construct a car. It would be much nicer if we could specify a different picture for every car. So let's do that. I'd like you to write another constructor that takes two arguments, the fuel efficiency and the picture file to be used. Go ahead and do that in the coding environment and submit your answer.